Hi everyone, welcome back to Samara Studio. In this video, we are going to listen to Just an Illusion multitrack, and you'll also hear my own mix of the song. If you want to listen directly to the mix, I'll put a timestamp in the video. Before we dive into the mix, let's add a little bit of context. This song was recorded in 1982 at Redbus Recording Studios. I couldn't find the exact details on how it was done, nor could I locate the list of equipment they had back in the days, but it was recorded on analog tape. The interesting thing is that I have 25 tracks here, while analog tapes typically had 24. I highly doubt they paired two 24 tracks just for one extra track. So it's possible that some tracks are missing. However, the song seems to be pretty similar to the original. Another curious aspect is that I had to do a certain amount of editing to match the original intro closely. This song was released in three different versions, each with different lengths. So it's likely that the three versions were edited in different ways using the same bass. I don't really know for sure, but the intro I have here was a bit short. I could have created the exact original intro with that, but it would have required too much work for that. So so let's see what we have here, shall we? So on the first track here, which is track 7 on the console, I have a synth track which sounds like this. And it's a loop going through the whole song. It's just this. The effects I put on there was just a chorus on my RMX16, and that's pretty much it about it. On the second track here, we have a synth solo that was not on the commercial version, and it sounds like this. Then on track 10 on the console is I think it's the piano part of the piano solo of the song. Yes, it is. On this piano part, I did put a Distressor to have a very percussive, this very punchy sound on the piano. So that's how it sounds without the Distressor. And that's how it sounds with the Distressor. Without. So there you go, that's the piano part. What do we have next on track 11? That's another synth part. We put a little bit of reverb in it. What do we have on track 12? So that's the Rhodes melody looping through the whole sound, the whole song. That's how it sounds dry. And with the reverb. So that's the Rhodes. Then there's another part of Rhodes, a stereo Rhode. Mm-hmm. And then we have a bass track. So track 15 is a bass synth track that I printed because it went through my DBX 510 subharmonic synth just to add some low end to the original bass track. And also there's a side chain going through because the kick is pulling down the bass, and that's how it sounds with the kick in the side chain. That's without the side chain. So there you go. Then we do have the kick, just right there. And the kick is going through the DBX 510 in real time. That's how it sounds without the 510. That's with the 510. That's without. And that's with it. Okay, so that's enough of the kick. Let's hear the snare. So that's the snare. Let's listen to the hi-hat. And I didn't put the gate on the snare, by the way. It's, the original track is like this. I did put a little bit of EQ on the hi-hat. I did remove a little bit of a high end, did put a little bit of like minus 5 dB at 10k shelf, because it's a little bit stingy on the high end. That's without, and that's with the EQ. Then we have like a overhead pair right here. It's only cymbals that were recorded without the drums, actually. So you can only hear a cymbal here and a cymbal there. There's nothing much going on there. Then we have some claps, a stereo pair of claps. I did put the reverb on the claps. That's how they sound without the reverb. So these are the claps. Then we have a cabasa. Unfortunately, the cabasa, I did put my Eventide DSP 7500, but just before I started recording the video, I smelled like the scent of something burning, and it was my DSP there. There's a driver just fried in it, as you can see in the pictures there. It will have to go to the repair shop. So what I did with the cabasa and the DSP was just I did put what they call the FM Pana preset on it at the rate of 0.5 of a hertz. It was just moving the cabasa around between left and right. So then we have a tambourine. It's just a basic tambourine going through the whole song. I think I did put a little bit of a chorus to give it a little bit more width. So that's the tambourine. Then what do we have? The vocal tracks. So let's hear. Listen to it with that EQ.
Searching for a destiny that's mine.
You can hear the S's.
There's another place.
Really aggressive.
Touching many hearts along the way, yeah. Hoping that I'll never have to say it's just an illusion. Searching for a destiny that's mine.
So I did put a... It needs a little bit of a de-esser, but the problem is that the S's are not always on the same spot of the frequency spectrum. But I did put a little bit of an EQ there.
Searching for a destiny that's mine. There's another place, another time.
Just to soften the vocals a little bit, because they're a little bit aggressive to me. So that's it for the lead vocal. We do have backing vocals that we have a pair of them. I did put the backing vocals through my Elysia XFilter 500, but I did use my XFilter for another thing, so it's not in the correct setting anymore, but you're gonna hear it all mixed, but you can listen to it without without the XFilter. And you can hear the reverb behind it. That's without the reverb. You can hear some artifacts of the tape of the punching.
Could it be that?
The punching, you can hear the machine going up in speed.
Could it be that? Put me back. Could it be that?
So that's what we have here.
Could it be that?
A bit of reverb, of course. The same reverb is used throughout the whole song.
Could it be that?
So that's one track. There's another track right here.
It's just an illusion.
There you go. On this one, there was already
and
some...
all this confusion.
Some effects on it, but I did put reverb.
It's just an illusion.
So there you go. Next, that's the last track. What do we have here?
Illusion.
Okay, that's the illusion part going through it.
Illusion.
I did put an EQ on both track 21 and track 30 because they would sound a little bit. There's a load of a low end that I had to remove. So
illusion.
That's with the EQ.
Illusion.
That's without the EQ.
Illusion.
And that's all for the individual tracks, so let's hear the final mix, shall we?
Illusion.
Just an illusion.
Could it be that?
And all is confusion.
Yeah.